This chapter is forms of business organization. This is the second chapter in business studies. Now, see, we were discussing in chapter one about business and what are the ways in which business can be opened. What is the ways in which an organization can be established? So, in detail, we are going to understand about the different ways or forms of business organization. Okay. Now, moving forward, first let's see what are the different forms of business organization. As you can see here, we have the sole proprietorship, we have a company, we have a joint stock company, a cooperative society, a joint Hindu family, and a partnership. Now, each one of the form has its own merits and demerits. So, we are going to understand each form, try to see if we can understand through a live example. So, we'll also discuss on a real life example and we'll see both the features, merits, demerits, and what is the distinction and to which size of business it is useful. Let's start with sole proprietorship. Now, before we start with sole proprietorship, let me discuss an example with you. So, let us assume that we have this Miss Rama. Now, Miss Rama has a love for cooking. That is the reason she took a business, that is the reason she took a degree in cooking itself. So, she went to London, she took a degree in culinary arts and she came back to India. Now, instead of joining the restaurant as a chef, she decided to open her own kitchen. But here, the kitchen was providing tiffin services with a difference. What was the difference? The difference here was that instead of providing the regular tiffin services, she was providing dietary food, which was needed by film stars or people who are very conscious about their body or they want to build a particular body. So, this was the focus which was going to do. Now, Rama wanted to know and understand which form of organization would be suitable for her. So, let's start with sole proprietorship. Now, see, when you're starting a business, sole proprietorship is the most common way in which a business is started. Why? Here, because the business is managed and controlled by single individual. So, in our example, Rama doesn't have anybody. She wants to start her own business. So, she would be the person who would be managing and responsible for Rama's kitchen. Okay. Now, the next is, when I'm talking about sole proprietorship, what is the meaning of this? Remember, sole and proprietor, these are the two words which have been combined together to get the word sole proprietorship. What is sole proprietorship? Sole means one and proprietor is the owner. Okay, so this is what one owner, when I'm talking about sole proprietorship, it is one owner who runs the business. Now, so as I told you already, sole proprietorship is one owner or only owner of the business. As I already said, it is suitable for small businesses like Rama's kitchen. She started on a very small scale. She's a one-man show right now. So, she has started the business. It would be suitable for her to start on a sole proprietorship basis. Now, here she would be able to give personalized services. What she can do is, based on the diet which has been given to her customers, she can customize and provide them the tiffin services. So, she can maintain that one-to-one relationships if needed with her customers. Okay. Now, to take few examples, now already I discussed with you Rama's kitchen. Any other example here would be, for example, the Kiriana store. If we go to the market, when we want to buy something, the local Kiriana store is always a sole proprietorship. Now, there are certain definitions which are being given and which you need to understand and write when you're writing your exams. These would be the definitions which you need to produce. The best way to remember a definition is to remember the few important words of the definition. The rest of the words fit in as you remember these words. So, what is the first definition? Let's see. Now, this definition has been given to us by J.L. Hansen. What is this definition? See, what does he say? Sole trader is a type of business. So, remember, a type of business person, a type of business unit where a person is solely, so you need to remember, solely responsible for providing the capital. So, remember the word capital, and then he has to bear the risk. So, for bearing the risk of the enterprise and for the management of the business. So, if you remember type of business unit, solely responsible, capital, bearing the risk, and management of business, the entire definition will automatically come to your mind. Now, this is the first definition which is being given to us by J.L. Hansen. There is a second definition which is by L.H. Haney. Okay, now what does this definition say? It says that the individual proprietorship, that is sole proprietorship in other words, is a form of business organization at the head. So remember, the word head stands an individual as one who is responsible, who directs. So remember, the word responsible directs its operation and who alone runs the risk of failure. So remember the word risk of failure. So this is how the definitions need to be remembered when you're learning them for the examination purpose. Okay, now moving further, let's understand what are the features. So the first feature is formation and closure. See, forming a sole proprietorship form of business organization is very easy. You really don't need much of legal formalities to be completed when compared to other forms of organization. For example, in Rama's kitchen, what would be the formalities she need to do? She doesn't have to take a registration like partnership or any other form of organization, but because she is running a kitchen, so there would be certain certifications and licenses which she need to take from the authorities. So remember, there are very few legal formalities to be completed. Now, there is no separate law on sole proprietorship. So there are no additional formalities which a sole proprietor has to look into. Because of this, it is very easy to close the business. So tomorrow, if Rama wants to close her Rama's kitchen, what she all has to do is wind up the business, sell the assets, and the closure is done. Okay, so this is the first feature of sole proprietorship. Now moving forward, the second feature is unlimited liability. Now let's assume, suppose Rama's kitchen doesn't do well, and due to this the problem happens is she goes into losses and she decides to wind up, but before wind up she has to pay to the creditors. Suppose in that example, her creditors, the due to the creditors is 80,000, whereas the assets she has and the business money she has is only 50,000. So clearly there is a excess 30,000 which needs to pay. So here in sole proprietorship, what happens? It is Rama who will have to pay from her personal income or personal savings because she has unlimited liability. So this is a feature of sole proprietorship, that they have unlimited liability and they have to bear the losses from their personal income. The next feature is sole risk bearer and profit recipient. Now here what happens is the proprietor has to bear all the risk. As I gave you the example, if there are losses, it was Rama who had to bear the losses and pay to the creditors. But suppose, now assume, if she had done the profit of 1 lakh in the first year, the entire profit would have been hers. She don't have to go and share the profit with anyone else. So here she is the sole recipient of the profit and the direct reward is given to her because she is the only risk bearing person in the organization. Now, control. See, a sole proprietor will have the entire control to run the business. So in Rama's kitchen, the example which we are doing, it would be Rama who would be running the business, controlling the business. So she will be making all the decisions which are required for doing it. There is no separate entity. See, when I'm talking about this form of organization, sole proprietor, that is Rama, and sole proprietorship, that is the business, Rama's kitchen, they are one and same person. They are not identified as two different individuals by the law. So when someone is suing Rama's kitchen, for example, if she is not able to deliver the quality of food and someone decides to take her to the legal liability, in that scenario what would happen is she would be the person who would be solely responsible. So the business and the business owners are one and they are responsible for all the acts of the business and the activities of the business. Lastly, lack of business continuity. Let's assume tomorrow, unfortunately, Rama suffers an accident and she dies in that. So what will happen to Rama's kitchen? The business gets closed. The same happens with if she goes insane, if there is any kind of imprisonment, or if there is a physical inability or ailment, or even if she goes bankrupt, then she won't be able to continue her business. So this is a feature which we need to remember, that if something happens to sole proprietor, that if something happens to Rama, Rama's kitchen gets closed. Now let us quickly discuss the merits. Now they are mostly taken from the features itself, so you will be able to understand them easily. The first thing is quick decision making. Now if you remember, in features we discussed that they are the sole decision makers in the organization, so they can make a decision quickly. For example, tomorrow if she gets a very a lucrative business opportunity, she doesn't have to wait to get the approval or to go and talk to someone else who is also in control of business. She's the only person who is going to make a decision, so she can make it quickly and take the advantage of the situation. The same is, she can, as I just said, she can capitalize on the opportunities. Now, confidentiality of information. See, she is not, a sole proprietorship is not required to publish the books of accounts, or the books of accounts are not publicly available. So the confidentiality of information remains. What happens when other forms of organization, for example company, they have to publish their annual reports. So a competitor can take advantage from getting information from the annual reports. This problem is not there when it comes to sole proprietorship. Okay, the next is direct incentive. As we discussed already in features, because she is the sole owner and the risk bearer, so she doesn't need to go and share the profits of the business with someone else. Similarly, she will be the person who will be getting the maximum incentive out here. Now, there is a sense of accomplishment. When Rama's kitchen reaches to certain level, let's say it becomes a household name after few years, it is a sense of accomplishment for a sole proprietor because they have achieved something in life. The other thing is, most of the people nowadays don't like the 9-to-5 job because it has a lot of stress and you're doing the work for someone else. So when you're doing the work for yourself, it gives you, you become your own boss and it gives you highest level of satisfaction. Lastly, as I said, it is easy to form and easy to close. You don't have to take much registrations as we require in other forms of business. Similarly, if you want to close the business, you can just sell it off and move away from the business. Now, let's do demerits of sole proprietorship. So the first demerit is limited resources. See, when Rama started her Rama's kitchen, she had to use her personal savings. The reason, she was a fresh graduate, she had taken a degree in culinary arts, so she didn't have much of credibility that a bank would give her loan. Okay, even if bank would have given her loan, she would require to keep collaterals, that is, she need to keep some of her personal assets as collateral. So the first demerit is, there are limited resources available when we are opening a sole proprietorship, and most of the times the personal savings are used by the person who is opening this form of organization. The next is limited life. See, a sole proprietorship would have limited life because if there is death, illness, insolvency, the business has to be closed down. Other thing is, let's assume if Rama becomes, you know, she suffers from cancer, unfortunately. And obviously, you know that cancer treatment takes time. So for that entire time being, she won't be able to run her business efficiently. So that will also affect the life of the business. Now, unlimited liability, as I already gave you an example about the creditors, which we were talking about, 1 lakh was due. And if she was able to only get have 50,000 as business income, she'll have to pay the 50,000 from her own personal savings. So this is a demerit, that they have unlimited liability. Now, they have limited managerial ability. See, when Rama opened her Rama's kitchen, she'll have to do everything from getting the raw material, that is the vegetables, wheat, everything, to delivering, to doing the marketing, to keeping the books of accounts. Initially, they have to do everything because the business cannot afford to hire professionals who charge a high price. So what happens is, because they are concentrating on so many things, they become jack of all trades but master of none. And hence their managerial ability gets affected due to this, and hence at sometimes the business performance gets affected. Now let's do a real life example. You remember eBay. Now eBay was started as wherein a place where you can actually sell your used items. How does this organization start? See, today this organization is a company. It's a large grown company having offices in the entire world. But initially it was started with Perio Omidyar when he got an idea that, you know, there is a market where people want to buy the used items and there are people who are willing to sell their used items such as mobile phones or even used cameras, etc. So eBay is a example of sole proprietorship. Now remember, when a sole proprietorship is a small form of business, initially most of the businesses start in this format, and once they start growing, then they convert in any other form of business organization. Now this ends the video. In the next video, we are going to do joint Hindu family business. Okay.